That was music from Carlos Arraiza, one of the guests right now, and the music you'll be hearing at Teatro Latino, which hits the Bay Area this weekend. It's a wonderful opportunity for you to be thoroughly entertained in a different way in live theater. Carlos Arraiza, as I mentioned, is a multi-musicianist who's be doing the musical performance at Teatro Latino, and Giovanni Rodriguez, who's the director of one of the segments of Teatro Latino and also the organizer of Teatro Latino. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Giovanni, tell me, what is Teatro Latino?
Teatro Latino is our monthly event for May at the Speakeasy Salon, which is a monthly celebration of theater, arts, and culture in the East Bay, co-sponsored by 5&0 Arts and Culture, which is an arts association, and the Speakeasy Theater Company. For the May event, we're also co-sponsored by La Peña Cultural Center.
Excellent. Now, we have a segment of one of the portions of Teatro Latino. Why don't you set it up for us?
Right. This is a very short segment from a very short play by Octavio Solis, and we're very proud to be doing, to be staging the world premiere.
And one that you directed?
Yes.
Okay. Let's take a look at that right now.
In that sliver, chrome on the fender, father's keys, the glasses of the man across the street, a silver jet roaring above, a watch on someone's wrist, a strip of tinfoil in the street, a million speckles on the sidewalk, a sun encased in every one of them. Everything is catching light, everything around me, fires of each other. Papa, what's he doing? Tiny fires everywhere. Copies of fires far off, in ignorance of us. But our things catch it. What is he carrying? What is he? Someone opens a window. The sun rams its whole eye in mine. Papa, he's throwing it. That smell is me. That noise is me. That fire is me. The whole day is charred, white.
Is she going to be one of the performers?
Yes. Kyla Brown is a student at Black Pine Circle. Black Pine Circle is our landlord. We lease the theater from them.
One way to pay them rent.
Yes.
What other performances that we have scheduled for Teatro Latino?
Well, I should explain that Teatro Latino, being part of the Speakeasy Salon, is both theatrical performance and musical performance. We have one other theatrical performance, which is the Latina Theater Lab. The Latina Theater Lab is a collective of Latin American actresses that do cabaret-style comedy theater. So it's quite different from the segment we just saw.
So you're going to have a series of different segments throughout the performance. It's not like one whole act. It's a series of them.
Right. It's a series of performances, and should also emphasize that it's also a party. And that's where Carlos comes in.
Carlos, what kind of music are you going to be playing for us?
Oh, yeah, it is party music. It's all original salsa with a political twist, and it's very happening for at least the events, the political events of the time. And it is dance music, so please come down. Everybody have a good time. We're going to party. And I've hired about 7 of the best musicians that from this Bay Area, from all the best bands. We've done together conjunto, conjunto Araiza, let's call it.
Right.
And all original sounds for this May 11th gig at Speakeasy Theater.
And you'll be on at the closing portion?
We'll be on from 10 to question mark. We'll go on until they throw us out.
Close the house down, in other words. What kinds of musical styles are you more accustomed to, or that you're more known for playing?
Well, I'm more known for playing the salsa style of music, though I perform, jazz and classical and Latin rock and everything, but I mostly do salsa music, and I've toured and taken my originals in Europe and South America, and basically that's my main drive with my originals. That's how I write, my main form, basically.
Excellent. Now, Giovanni, how do you go about getting performers like Carlos to come to the performances here at Salon?
Oh, it's not easy, but it's word of mouth. We've produced, I think this is our 6th Speakeasy Salon, our 6th monthly event. Mm-hmm. And so we're building some relationships with the theater and the musical performance community. And Carlos was referred to us actually by the Latina Theater Lab.
Oh, got a reputation following
already. Yes, he does.
Now, is the Teatro Latino just for Latino audiences, or can non-Latinos also gain something from attending this performance?
No, it's not just for Latino audiences. We're trying to achieve several things, and one is to introduce Latin American theater to non-Latinos. Mm-hmm. We think that there are very interesting things going on in Latin American theater today that is actually having some influence in the mainstream theatrical community. Theater goers are familiar with this, but non-theater goers are not familiar with this.
So is there like a message you're trying to give through through the performance?
Well, yeah, not so much a message, but we do feel it's important to expose non-Latinos to Latin American theater.
So it's a commentary on what's going on with Latinos. And
yeah, more, a commentary, but also just a chance to expose non-theater goers to something they might not be familiar with.
Now, the way you've set it up, you were telling me before, is more of a cabaret style, where you've got people sitting around tables and you have row seating and all, but it's more of a festive atmosphere when you go to one of these things, right?
Oh, yeah. It's not like your regular theater. We do have row seating, but we also have about 10 to 12 round tables with candles and sofas in the back of the theater. When you walk in, it's a lot more homey and relaxed than a regular theater.
So not your traditional theater style. Mm-hmm. And that, of course, would allow you, Carlos, to really play to the audience with your music. And you mentioned something about the political themes in some of the salsa music. What about the emergence of salsa music recently? We hear a lot more of it on the radio. What do you think about that?
Well, it's crossing over, like we were talking earlier, in the house and techno sounds. You can go to a nightclub and hear it mixed in with like a disco beat salsa. But this isn't really salsa. It's more like just a mixture into the techno sound. But as far as salsa itself, in the city, there are a lot of bands coming out right now, so you can catch a lot of new acts in town. Just when you look in the Sunday paper in the pink section, you'll see a lot of new bands, a lot more new groups, and look for Conjunto Araiza, please, too. We're out there. But yeah, there's a lot happening now with the salsa scene, but as far as what you were talking about in the clubs with the mixture of techno, yeah, that's a whole new venue. That's a whole new thing that I'm actually probably going to be tapping into, because I have a recording studio, and it's nice to expand. But still, the traditional salsa is what I'll be presenting the night of this performance, with the real horn section, not synthesized, you know. So you can catch a típico salsa, you know, come down and just Puerto Rican Cuban style, basically.
Any other musical styles we could get? Maybe some jazz or something else you've mixed in with?
Oh, at this gig we're going to I'll throw in some bomba and different Caribbean rhythms, but not particularly setting up any cumbias or anything like this at the time, though it could be done. We basically set up a straightforward salsa set, okay, so people can really do some nice, serious salsa dancing, and maybe we'll do a little introduction to some dance steps when people get there, for those who might be a little shy and afraid to go out there, because we want people to dance. We play better if everybody dances, we'll play better. So
right, everybody's enjoying themselves,
exactly,
and really taking part of it. Well, it sounds like a wonderful event on May 11th, and we want to let you know at home how to get in touch with the people that are putting this together. Teatro Latino, it's Saturday, May 11th, from 8 to 11 p.m. at the Speakeasy Theater, 2016 7th Street in Berkeley, California. You can call them at 510-845-4100. In the time we have left, let me ask you, what would you tell some of our young people out there who are interested in getting into performing arts? What kind of advice would you give them? Let me start with you, Giovanni.
Well, if you're interested in theater performance, the Speakeasy will certainly welcome you. We're a young theater company. We're very interested in working in Latin American theater. We hope actually to produce a play by Octavio Solis this fall, so we will be looking for Latin American artists. Not just theatrical performers, but actually musical performers. The two plays that we're looking at that Solis wrote are musicals. Mm-hmm. Actually, it's probably more accurate to say that they're plays with music.
Right. So they just should come by the theater and come by and audition for it, or on the spot. Carlos, how about you for the younger audiences out there that are interested in getting into music?
Well, I was actually worried about this for a minute, because I didn't see a lot of younger musicians in the salsa scene. But now, believe it or not, I've seen a lot more early 20s, even teenagers who are now coming out in piano players, percussionists in the salsa scene. I'm really happy to say that I'm seeing this happen. Some of the youth are getting involved. So my advice to the youth would be to approach the salsa musicians who are established, the masters, so be it, and ask that you want to take lessons, private lessons with these people, and learn and hang with the masters. That's the only way to do it. Or go to the Mission Cultural Center, for example. They have classes in percussion and the style of Latin music. But there seems to be a surge of more youth getting involved, which is great, because I thought I was the old school on the, like, the last of the falsetto, right? But no, this is starting to happen again. So the youth shouldn't be shy. Just approach the musicians, and we're basically open to that. You know, someone approaches me, yeah, sure, we do private instruction. Most musicians have their card, and sir, give me a call. No problem. Don't be shy. You know, the kids got it.
All right. Giovanni, Carlos, thanks for being here, and we're going to leave you now with some music, some more music by Carlos Araiza, Ese Conjunto, and we also want to remind you to stay tuned. Janice Edwards is next with Black Renaissance. Hasta la próxima.